Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging hour discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cucchiara, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome in. Good afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you so much for spending some time with us this afternoon. Just a reminder for those just tuning in, you can listen to us a couple different ways. One is on the radio at KDOW 1220 AM. You could also listen to us live online anywhere at kdow.biz. And we would also love to have you download a podcast. That way you could take the show, listen to it anywhere. You go to our website at reradiolive.com. You could download the podcast there, or you go to iTunes or all the normal places that have the apps to download. We'd love to have you do that. It's growing rapidly, and we realize not everybody could listen to the show from 3 to 4, but we want to give you an opportunity to listen to this great content and education information on a daily basis. We're with you 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, from 3 to 4. We are the only live 5-day-a-week real estate-related show, continuing to grow in the Bay Area and having a lot of fun. The focus is education and information. So just like today, we're going to be having a topic and experts around helping you in and out of the real estate, really making you a more wise consumer, giving you a lot of information and helping you make some decisions in and around real estate. That's what we do for sure. With that, again, we're a live show. Before I invite my guests in, you could contact us and interact with us two ways during the show. One is a toll-free number, which is 1-800-516-1220, or there's the text line. A lot of people like to text their questions in. That's 408-838-9060. And if you're listening to the podcast, the best way to communicate with us is the text line, 408-838-9060. Let me invite my guests in, Cindy Hofen and also Karen Jones. They're both with Managing Moves and More. Cindy's president Managing Moves and More, and Karen is a director of sales and marketing. Welcome in, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Yeah, good to have you guys here. We met a couple of months ago, and I'm excited to have you on the show. This is a big part of real estate, what you guys do. And, you know, a lot we talk about buying, selling, financing, tax, and legal. There's so many things around real estate, but one of the most important things is, and you guys know this, when you get ready to move, it's a very emotional, it's stressful, and picking the right company and the right people to handle that is really important, and you guys do a great job in that area, so we're going to talk about that. If you could, each of you maybe just take a minute or so and let us give us an idea of your background and then current roles and responsibilities with Managing Moves and More.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
After a circuitous route, the fateful time for me was I helped my mother-in-law move in Kansas. And after doing that, I realized I enjoyed that very much. I returned to California, and then in 2009, I started Managing Moves and More. And since then, we've helped 1,000 clients.
Wow.
We really started the business with a focus on just helping seniors, but based on our demand, we've expanded our service, and now we work with a broad range of clients.
Wonderful. Very good. Karen?
So I'm Karen Jones, and I'm the director of sales at Managing Moves and More. Mm-hmm. I was born and raised in the Bay Area and have a family with 3 kids who are all getting older and, and going out and, you know, going to school.
Yes.
And so I thought maybe I would look into going back to work. And Managing Moves and More was just right up my alley. I'd done a lot of volunteering, and at the end of the day, felt great about the volunteering. And I kind of feel that way after my days with my clients from Managing Moves and More.
Yeah. I think when we met, we talked originally. You guys, one of the reasons I believe you started with the senior citizens, I mean, there's such a need there. And I know both of you have a caring heart for people in general. And that, of course, was a natural transition for you. And now the business has grown to where you're really helping anybody in the areas. And is it
right.
Mostly just in the Bay Area? Give us a little idea of where you guys serve your clients' needs.
So we work anywhere from South San Francisco all the way down through Morgan Hill.
Okay.
And then a little bit on either side of the Bay.
All right. Very good. Well, let's talk a little bit about the market. So are you guys busy? If so, what is that a result of kind of the crazy real estate market is? I mean, we see it, a lot of movement. There's certainly a lot of people coming in that want to move here for jobs and for lifestyle, what have you. But then I guess there's also people that are moving out, right? We forget about those people.
That's right.
So give us a little idea about the marketplace right now.
Okay. Obviously, we live, I think, in the best place on earth.
I would agree.
a lot of people want to move here, and I'm sure as real estate agents feel a lot, the inventory isn't as high as they would like it to be. We think one of the reasons is that seniors typically want to stay in their homes. Mm-hmm. AARP says 85 to 90% of folks want to age in place.
Mm.
For those homes that do come on the market, frequently and often they're seniors who have lived in their home for 30-plus years and realize that they may not be able to stay in their home.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're looking at this as a great time
to
make that shift to something else. So that's those are our main clients.
Yeah, and I would I certainly don't want to put words in your mouth, but I think we talked about it again when you guys were here first. And what I hear a lot, especially let's take the elderly. I mean, these are people in some cases have been in their home 20, 30, 40, maybe 50 years. We had a lady in our neighborhood that was the same thing right next door to us. And I saw how difficult it was for her to finally make that decision to move out. So I guess my point is you guys are working with people in some cases that, you know, they created memories here, they raised families, they created friendships throughout the neighborhood. So it can't just be this, back up the truck, come on guys, load the boxes and go, can it? I mean, tell us about your approach and why it's so unique and why you guys are so successful and why it's so important to really get to know these people and help them transition.
Mm-hmm. You know, you do build a lifetime of memories when you live in your house for so long, and everything you own has a story.
Mm.
Everything is a memory. And for most people, loving memories of growing up with a family. So then when it comes time to think about moving, all of a sudden you start looking around thinking, oh my goodness, I have lots of things. And it's a lot about change.
Yeah.
And it means that their life is changing, and that's very difficult to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do is we go in and basically partner with a client, and we work together to help them. Typically, that's about creating a floor plan for where they are going so we know how much they can take. But it's definitely a process, and sometimes clients can do it quickly. A lot of times it takes clients a long time because they want to tell the story of everything they own before they give it away.
Yeah.
And many of our clients are very accomplished people. And the things that they have, they've worked long and hard and many hours to receive the plaques or to receive, you know, these items.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not easy just to say, okay, I'm going from a three-bedroom three-story house to a one-bedroom apartment. And what am I going to take that I'm going to look around every day and say, okay, these things make me happy.
Yeah.
It's scaling down like
that. Yeah, no, that's a good point. As you're talking, too, I'm thinking those plaques, the trophies, the awards, and let's just even forget about it, but then there's the pictures, right, the family pictures, friendships, wedding, kids, all those types of things. They now come off the walls. And just that happening, going in the boxes and transitioning and stuff like that, sometimes when we're younger and we think about real estate, I know sometimes it's easy to get caught up in, okay, you know, we just got to get the loan in and get it closed and on time. And there's people, there's emotions, and there's relationships here. And you guys probably see it more than anyone.
It's the perfect time to bring in a senior move manager because they really work together with the real estate agent.
Right.
The real estate agent is trying to get the house on the market, and they have a timeline as well. When's the best time to put the house on the market? And then bringing in a senior move manager, we come in and we deal with all the things inside the house and where things are going to go.
Yeah. Are your clientele, I mean, is it still predominantly the older generation, or are you seeing a kind of a switch of that, or maybe a change in a little bit, or is it a mix? What percentage-wise do you you have?
You know, we still see a high senior population that we work with because, you know, we have a great expertise there. But it's interesting because as people find out what we do, and what we do, too, is pretty generic. You know, we help downsize and organize, pack, unpack. We're seeing younger families who are busy and they're moving to a new home. They'll have us come in and pack because they don't have time. So that's a client segment. Also, we do a little staging because that's a great transition when you're getting a senior ready or someone ready to sell their house. So really we're seeing our base of clients expanding quite a bit.
Got it. Well, that's probably a good time to we're going to take a break in the first couple of minutes, the next few minutes. But before we do that, talk a little bit about all the services because you just mentioned a couple. So that we know that the listeners or the people listening to the show understand there's a full kind of a gamut and host of services you guys offer. Can you go through that for me?
Okay, so we can do it in bullet points, but I think the best way to do it is to tell a story of one of our clients.
Okay.
And one of my first clients was in San Francisco. She was a widow, and she had no children. And she had a three-bedroom home in San Francisco, a three-story home in San Francisco, moving into her one-bedroom apartment. And so we went up there, and I met with the real estate agent, got a timeline of what needed to be done by when. And then the client and I met, and we figured out a floor plan. You can't take everything with you. And so what can you take? What's going to fit in there? What's going to be around you that you love? And so we kind of went through that process. Turned out she had 9 closets of clothes, and those things were super important to her. I can continue the story.
Yeah, go ahead.
So we downsized her clothes, which were her pictures and her snapshot of her life. One outfit, she said, "Oh, I wore that when I met the Dalai Lama," or I wore that at Harvey Milk's funeral," or "I wore that to my husband's when he got a big award." So those things were super important for her. And every client is different. Some might be their library of 1,000 books. So you figure out what is important to them, and then you sort and organize of what you're going to take. And that's part of the process.
Yeah, and I would guess that again, I don't want to underestimate this. Is this is not something? Well, I guess you could do it, but you wouldn't be very popular, and you wouldn't get much business. That you just come in and say, "Hey, come on, let's get these box packs and let's go." This is so. It could be that way, right? And I'm guessing a lot of companies do that, but that's a mistake.
It's a lot of handholding.
Yeah.
It's a lot of walking them through the process to make them feel comfortable. And you're also not dealing with a 30, 40-year-old. You're 50, 60, 70, 80. And my client was 90 in San Francisco. So you have – there's a skill set that you have to learn to be able to do this job.
Very good. All right, we're going to take our first break. We're going to come back with much, much more. We're here with Cindy and Karen. They are with Managing Moves and More. If you have any questions about moving, maybe your parents, grandparents, yourself, you want to move, give us a call, check in, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text the questions to 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We're joined in studio today by Cindy Hofen, is that right? And Karen Jones. Cindy is the president. Karen is the director of sales and marketing. We're talking about their company, Managing Moves and More, how important it is. It's really a relationship business, and we're getting into the details of that and why it's so important and helping people transition. And before we get back into that, I just want to remind those listeners, too, on the fourth segment, we're going to invite in a good friend of mine, Andy Kush. We're going to be helping him promote the Jenny Red Classic, which is his wife passed away last year of cancer, and we are each year he is hosting a golf tournament, raising money for the cause, and a lot of fun, a great person, and a wonderful family. So we're going to help him. Segment four, we're going to help him promote and see if we could fill that golf course up. So, all right, ladies, let's get back to really, I guess first maybe talk about the senior move managers, because that's a big part I just want to make sure we highlight on. And then maybe just if you could tell us how one gets started. I mean, how does the process start? Let's say I'm, you know I should move. I know I need to move. My family might need to help me. Maybe it's me personally. But, you know, how does a person get started? Who do they call? Who do they know how to trust? And how does that whole process get started?
Okay. So Managing Moves and More is part of a national organization called the National Association for Senior Move Managers. And that is just like doctors and lawyers have an organization. That's our organization.
Okay.
And we provide training and continuing education. As part of that, you need to be licensed, bonded, and approved. And this association came out of a realization that more and more seniors were moving and really needed supportive help that they could trust. National Association of Realtors also recognized that when they designated the senior real estate specialist.
Yeah,
so
right.
There's a lot more visibility out there, realizing that the gray tsunami, as they call it, or the silver tsunami, is coming, and we really need to provide support services around that.
I mean, isn't it true also that, I mean, we don't want to get dramatic, but the reality is this, senior citizens are taken advantage of all the time.
It's
well documented. You know, finances, cold calls. There's a reason why a lot of these scam artists go after the senior citizens, because they're vulnerable. And and so even more important to establish this trusting relationship, and the reason for the designation that you guys have is important for sure.
Right.
Well, if you could take us through now, how does one get started in this process? And now I'm ready to move. I know I'm ready to move. Or let's say my grandmother, grandfather, I'm going to help, and I'm a family member. How do we get started?
So I think the hardest part is just getting started.
Making that decision.
And I think also it's don't feel like you have to take on the whole project all at once.
Okay.
It's taking little pieces, piece by piece by piece, and kind of getting into a rhythm like that. And once you start, whether it could be a drawer, a cabinet that you are cleaning out that will lead to a closet or a garage. So that's where the senior move managers come in, and we say, okay, we have like a tagging system. This is for family and friends. This is for a donation. And once you start organizing it that way, it becomes clearer in your mind.
Okay.
So that's kind of how I
started. So make the decision and realize that you could do it piece by piece. You don't have to do it all overnight. And so you guys, I'm sure, help when you come in and consult with them to talk about this too.
And I think also the thing to tell the clients or talk with the real estate agents and say, if you have a client who's thinking about moving, do it now.
Yeah.
Start this process now where you have time and options to be able to allocate your things that you want. And where you want them to go. Because the smaller time frame, it's a little bit trickier.
Yeah. We have a little. We have a minute or so to go here. So when we come back, I want to talk a little more about once you get started, kind of the next steps, and then how long does it take? You know, is it coordinating with families? I mean, does that become difficult and challenging? I'm guessing sometimes it might be easier when you're working with one person. I guess sometimes you guys also maybe communicate with other parts of the families. Is that right, when you do this type of thing?
Yeah, sometimes the kids are involved and sometimes they're not.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, the client is always the client.
Right.
Even no matter who's paying, we really focus on the client and their needs.
Right.
And so ultimately, they make the decisions as much as they're capable of doing.
Okay. All right, we're going to take another break. When we come back, much more. Again, if you have anyone that needs to move and you're concerned, worried, be a great time to call the experts, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text your questions to 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart. Tune in and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. As we continue on here, we have our guests in the studio, Cindy and Karen. Cindy is the president of Managing Moves and More, and Karen is sitting alongside. She's the director of sales and marketing, talking about how important it is to team up with the right moving company and build the relationship of people you could trust in such an important endeavor, for sure. So let's jump back right away, ladies. And take us through the process from start to finish.
Okay, so I kind of started with my client in San Francisco, mm-hmm. and how we met. We created a plan. Mm-hmm. We set expectations of what's going to happen. Then we did the floor plan. We have the three-story house moving into the one-bedroom apartment. And then we sort and we organize. What mm-hmm. are we going to take? What's going to be your happiness around you when you mm-hmm. get to that one bedroom? And then a couple days before the move, our group comes in and we pack. Mm-hmm. And we pack really well. And it's, you know, you realize that you're packing things that are someone's lifelong possessions that they got on some trip in some mm-hmm. Faraway place. So we pack, and then the day of the move, our movers show up. And we have a team at the one-bedroom apartment. The movers put everything on the truck. We take it to the apartment, and we now unpack. And we unpack everything. We can hang pictures on the walls. We put things in the cupboards. They are sleeping in their same bed with their sheets. We've mm-hmm. taken pictures of some of the stuff, like the chair with the cocktail table next to it with the vase on it, because that makes her happy, and we set that up. Yeah. So when she gets to her apartment, there's some familiarity mm-hmm. around there. Mm-hmm. And then by the end of the day, usually one day, boxers are gone, and they're set up and ready to mm-hmm. go. And I think that's one of the best things about this job, is when you first have that initial meeting, they're looking at you with, like, deer in the headlights. And at the end of the project, at the end of the move, they're comfortable in their new mm-hmm. space, and there's just a sense of peace yeah. for both parties of how we got there.
Yeah.
You know, because it does look daunting at the very beginning, but there is a sense of peace at the end of the project.
Yeah, that's good to hear. And I'm sure that you work mostly off referrals. After this many years, I'm sure you get a lot of referrals based on your business. What are the, if you had to distinguish a couple of different things, whether it's you, your staff, the way you guys handle things, how would you categorize to listeners today what makes you and your company different, and how you tick, and what would make you different than the average moving company?
You know, I would have to say that the best thing about our company is our staff. Mm. A lot of people, when they come to work for me, wanted to find a service job, mm-hmm. wanted to do something volunteer. Mm-hmm. But doing this position, a lot of them feel like they are providing a great service. And, you know, they have a part-time job. Mm-hmm. And so it's really a very gratifying business. And most of them have had parents or grandparents who they've had to help, mm-hmm. so they understand the process. So it's very natural and intuitive to them, and they really get it.
Yeah.
I think the other thing is also with our staff, they really take time to find out great new homes mm-hmm. for the people's belongings.
Yeah.
You can't take that dresser with you, but let's find a new home for it.
Yeah.
And we really spend a lot of time with the dispersal of yeah. of the client's items, which they really appreciate. Those were hard-earned yeah. items.
That's a good point. I didn't think about that. But when you're downsizing, in most cases they are, they have to make some tough decisions. And again, for some people I might say, oh, yeah. But no, these are lifelong. It could be something that was passed on to them or passed down to them, and all kinds of different, emotional connections to these things. So that is a strategy itself for mm-hmm. sure. All right, we're going to have to take another break. When we come back, we're going to take a break from moving, and we're going to move into talking to my good friend Andy Kush and a wonderful event he's going to be providing here for his wife. And we'll get more into that when we come back. Give us a call, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in a minute.
RERadiolive.com. That's RERadiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit RERadiolive.com. That's RERadiolive.com. again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We're going to take a break from our regular show today, which is great to give back. Real Estate Radio Live, I've been doing this show for almost 5 years, and we try as much as we can to give back to the community in many different ways that we can, and we love to do that on a regular basis. And today we have a good friend of mine on the line, Andy Kush, who I had the pleasure of meeting several years ago. We had some chance to work together, and lost his beautiful wife not too long ago to cancer. And so as Andy is a human being and a wonderful father and caring husband, he has put together a golf tournament to support the cause. And I want to introduce him in here and tell the story himself. Andy, good to have you here today.
Thank you, Joe. I really appreciate the time and the support, as always. Like you mentioned, April 7th last year, I lost my wife, Jennifer, we called her Jenny Red, to a 13-year battle with melanoma. Through that time, you know, doctors and you know, experts told her, you know, she couldn't, you know, probably shouldn't get married, probably shouldn't have a child and really, you know, live her young life, but she did all of that. Through that time and really towards the end of her life, it became really difficult to do, you know, the day to day things of, mm-hmm. you know, just getting around the house and maneuvering. And for me, you know, not knowing how to, you know, buy the supplies or to call the insurance or to do those sorts of things, it you know, kind of took away from some of that time. And so after she passed, I just had to kind of sit down and think and always, you know, I wanted to honor her. And we had so much love and support from our friends and coworkers and everybody kind of helping in and jumping in, whether it was a financial, bringing over meals or whatever it was. And so what I kind of found was that, you know, there are families just like mine that are, you know, are fighting cancer right now and have mm-hmm. these obstacles in their way, whether it's getting information, whether it's, you know, modifying their house or, you know, finding the right shower seat, you know, things that you just don't think about it until you have to. Right. And so, you know, the one thing that you and I both love is golf and, you know, loved tournaments and, you know, supporting different organizations around the Bay Area. And so this is, you know, my friends actually initially were set this tournament up to help support my family. And it was last June and, you know, unfortunately Jen passed away. We decided to keep on with the tournament because I knew there'd be others that needed that help. And so that's what we're going to continue to do is to, you know, help support Bay Area families you know, raise money and do what we can. You know, there's a lot of great organizations out there, whether it's, you know, helping finding cures and cancer's come a long way, but, you know, the people that have to fight and maybe sometimes don't get the most rosy of news are the ones that really need the help out there.
Yeah, good point. Well, Andy, let's tell us a little bit about the golf tournament, what the date, the time, and how people could participate.
Absolutely. So, it is at a course I'm pretty impartial to, Joe, as you know. It's a course at Winton Vineyard. It's kind of, if you say, my home
beautiful
course.
Beautiful course.
Probably my favorite in the Bay Area if I had to choose. And it's going to be, this year, it's going to be Friday, June the 10th. Again, it's at the course at Winton Vineyards. You know, kicking things off at about 8 a.m. It's a little earlier, so I know some people will have that Bay Area traffic troubles, but it is on a Friday, so I think, you know, getting in will be easy, so we're trying to get you out a little early. We'll tee off around 10 a.m., and Wente does a fantastic job of you know, supporting us. I happen to finally become a member, so they're really supportive and helpful and a great group. You know, they have a refreshments there for us. You know, we're going to have a great event. We, as you know, Joe, you know, some of those things you have to do in the golf tournament is you got to have a great course. You got to feed their mm-hmm. bellies, and you got to have some nice prizes. So a combination of all of those things that you'll see out there, you know, Giants tickets, football tickets, Raiders and Niners. We've got some autographs of Bay Area greats, you know, present and past. And as you know, Joe, I'm a diehard Chicago fan, but I'll keep my interest out of it. Yeah, I know, right? So,
that's wonderful.
I'll pay to the masses there. So this year we've in the past we sort of this last year we searched and found some families, and I donated to a bunch of different organizations last year. Because I really just didn't have the time that I needed to search out an organization mm-hmm. that I wanted to donate to, because essentially. I'd love for this to become something that where I can create a charity, but having a 4-year-old, being a T-ball coach, time doesn't permit at this time.
But I did
have the privilege of through different reaching out to different organizations. The American Cancer Society, they have the Relay for Life is a branch of them, but it, even deeper inside of that branch is it's called the Courageous Kids and a Day Away from Cancer. And what it does is it takes 600 young, kids, young adults that are right now battling cancer. And it's actually on Mother's Day this year. And they go to Great America and give them a day on the rides. They get to have a picnic lunch, arts and crafts, and a bunch
That's
of great
nice.
Activities, family portraits. So it's that same thing that I wanted to do. It's, just give back to the families, give them some time so they can – enjoy, basically, for lack of better terms, a day away from cancer. You see that on our website. We've got a couple of spots, Joe, where people can go and look at.
Let us know. What are the best parts? We got about a minute or so, Andy. What's the best
perfect.
Part to go and participate?
Absolutely. So JennyRedClassic.com. Jen was a redhead. So JennyRedClassic.com. It has, you can sign up. We have corporate sponsors and all the great information is there. The course information there and some great details about who we're donating this year to. If we've got Facebookers out there, which I know we do, just type in Jenny Red and you'll see this beautiful redhead. And that's the site we have dedicated to Jen. Again, telling more of our story and having all the details of the tournament.
All right, and I will we'll have it permanently fixed to our website as well. I want to thank you, Andy, for such a wonderful – I mean, this is just wonderful to see your good friend, and hopefully as many people as possible get out there and enjoy the experience and do something wonderful for not only your wife but the community, as you mentioned, and a lot of cancer survivors. So thanks for what you do.
Thank you, Joe. I appreciate the effort and time. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I will see you out there. Take care, buddy.
Okay, take care.
All right, we're going to take our last break, and we're going to come back, and we're going to finish up talking about moving. And if you have any questions about that, 1-800-516-1220, 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us today as we wind down the show. We are joined today in studio by Cindy and Karen. Cindy is the president of Managing Moves and More. Karen, the director of sales and marketing. And a lot of good information, extremely important. I could tell you from my own point of view, I'm in the industry. I help people finance. I work with real estate agents and financial planners, CPAs, a lot of people that are involved with people's life and their finances and making decisions. And I could tell you it's extremely important. So if you're out there and you're considering a move for you, your parents, grandparents, someone, you want to give these ladies a call because they do a great job. So why don't we, if you guys could kind of summarize kind of the importance and for us and take us before we have to duck out here today.
Yeah. What we as senior move managers, we really understand what this move is about and what this time of life is.
Mm-hmm.
These kinds of moves are the most anxiety-producing events through our lifespan. We can't underestimate how difficult it is for a senior. There's lots of people out there who don't have anyone, older folks who are widows or widowers. So finding someone to help them is a really, really important to help them manage the mm-hmm. process, because most of them honestly can't do it very well on their
right.
own. And our goal is to help them with this move to make it as stress-free as possible and help them have a new home that is safe, where they feel warm and well-kept mm-hmm. and cared for. Yeah.
Well said. Yeah, it's so important. Any final thoughts, Karen, in terms of that, too? I mean, it is important, and I think everybody should make sure that they hire the right company and right people to help you.
Yeah, I think just in closing that I just hope that everyone has a better understanding mm-hmm. of what senior move managers do and how it could make, by tapping into our resources, it makes your job easier and it makes the client just the transition just less stressful.
Yeah.
And that's a beautiful thing, you know, across the board.
And so just to be clear, too, you guys are in the Bay Area. This is as far north as San Francisco. Far south is Morgan Hill. Gilroy, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Morgan Hill?
Yes, Morgan Hill.
And then also, just so we're clear, too, obviously consumers. But the other thing I want to touch on, we have a lot of real estate agents and people in the industry that listen to the show and follow the show. So this is a great service for real estate agents to know about as well, right?
Right.
I mean, for their clients.
And one of the things that we would tell real estate agents is we'll take care of the heart and they take care of the home.
Ah, very good. I like it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, if you're again, if you're listening, if you're a consumer, if you're considering a move, even more importantly for your parents, grandparents, someone that really need assistance, you want to contact these ladies and have them help you out. And if you're in the real estate industry, if you're most people I know in the real estate industry like you guys, we rely on working together as a team. So when you have someone you could trust like yourself, if I'm a real estate agent and I know that I could trust my clients with you, I could take care of the house side, as you could say, take care of the heart side, and then really help those people with that transition. The teamwork is really important here. Very important here. All right, before we go, I want to make sure anyone listening, how would they get a hold of you? What's the best way to contact you if they want more information?
So the best way to contact us is through probably our website at www.managingmoves.com,
mm-hmm.
or you can contact us at 650-450-0928.
Great. And the website one more time was?
www.managingmoves.com.
Great. Ladies, I want to thank you for joining me today. It's very informational, a lot of good information. And again, for those that are tuning in for the show, thank you for listening today. I want to again thank you guys for showing up. It's been a great show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And if you want more information about the gals here at Managing Moves and More, you go to our website. The podcast will be available. And make sure to go to the website, reradiolive.com, to find out more about the Jenny Red Classic. We had Andy Kush on today to promote that cause as well. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thanks for tuning in today. Have a great afternoon. We'll be back with you tomorrow. Take care.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Tune in, log in, download our podcast. Discover more at reradiolive.com. reradiolive.com.